Hey, what's going on, everybody? Welcome back to the channel and happy St. Patrick's Day. In this video, I wanted to give my two cents on a discussion that I've been seeing take place over the past couple of weeks on Twitter in regard to 6v6 in Call of Duty. Now, I don't think I need to say this, but I'm just going to for the sake of clarity. There are millions of people who enjoy playing Warzone every single day. You might even be one of those people who love playing Warzone and prefer it now as your main Call of Duty entertainment. And if you are one of those people, congratulations, I'm glad that you find a lot of joy in it. But for the millions of other people, they don't. They just don't like Warzone. They don't like Battle Royale. They don't like the concept. Maybe they preferred Blackout. Maybe they just don't like how Warzone's being handled. And so they fall back to 6v6 or some other type of Call of Duty entertainment. Maybe it's zombies this year. And that is one thing that I can say for certain. Black Ops Cold War is in this weird juxtaposition where it seems to be simultaneously providing a ton of content, but at the same time making it feel like there's barely anything. And for most, that makes things feel pretty shallow. But if you look at it from the bigger picture, there really is a lot to do in Cold War. Going back to what I said a little bit earlier about people enjoying Warzone while other people don't enjoy Warzone, the same thing goes for Black Ops Cold War multiplayer. Maybe you enjoy playing 6v6, but at the same time, you just don't like playing zombies. Maybe you enjoy playing zombies, but at the same time, you can't stand the multiplayer. But just because you may not like something doesn't mean it's not there. So here's factually what you're able to do right now in Black Ops Cold War on March 17th, 2021. You have a fully robust campaign that features multiple playthroughs, multiple options, side missions, quests, and achievements that you can unlock. These achievements can then also be transferred in-game, which will allow you to get XP in multiplayer and calling cards to use in both Black Ops, Cold War, and Warzone. Your next option of play is multiplayer, where 6v6 resides, and there's currently 13 multiplayer maps to experience 6v6 on. We'll talk about this in just a moment, but Team Deathmatch, Hardpoint, Domination, Kill Confirmed, all the standards that you've normally come to know and love are all there, including new modes like VIP Escort, which is all playable in the 6v6 arena. We, of course, also had the return of Gunfight, which brought four of its own 2v2 maps to the game itself. These will most likely be expanded across the way, and we'll talk a little bit more about this in just a moment, so check the timestamps. But we also can't forget about Combined Arms, which is a larger multiplayer experience. It's kind of like the ground war of this game. It goes up to 24 players, and it takes place on larger versions of the 6v6 maps that we are currently playing in Black Ops Cold War. And finally, you can't forget about Fireteam Dirty Bomb, which is a completely new mode to Black Ops Cold War, something that we've never seen in Call of Duty before. This pits 10 teams of 4 against each other in a large map currently taking place on Ruka, Alpine, and Sanatorium. You have to collect, deliver, and deposit uranium into several active Dirty Bombs, and we've talked about this mode quite a bit on the channel. It's one of my favorites in Black Ops Cold War. But the rest of the multiplayer stuff kind of resides in the weekly updates that we get in regard to the playlists, and we'll see Snipers Only, Nuketown 24/7, Gunfight Blueprints, Knife Only playlists, stuff like that, which is something that we've seen in Call of Duty for the past few years. In the same vein of multiplayer, but still different, we have League Play, which was just added a couple of weeks ago. League Play offers a different type of ranking system while providing different rewards for those who play and different divisions for those who remain on top and win often. This is one of those modes that had a rocky start, and I think that it's still kind of rocky, but they've been updating it slowly but surely. Finally, we have Zombies, which offers the brand new Outbreak experience, a very large open world experience on the Fireteam maps, going against tons of zombies and trying to survive multiple difficulties. We have Firebase Z, D Machina, Dead Ops Arcade, Dead Ops Arcade First Person, which I believe that's probably going to end up staying in the game. And throughout Zombies, we have this robust upgrade system with the Ethereum crystals in order to upgrade your certain skills, perks, field upgrades, and much more. I mean, there's a lot in Zombies this year. So, going back to what I said at the beginning of this commentary, some people like Warzone and some people don't. The same could apply to everything I just talked about. You might like Zombies, you might not. You might like Fireteam, you might not. You might enjoy Gunfight, you might not. And for many people, it just leaves them with 6v6, which I agree 100% seems to be severely lacking this year. I think one of the biggest reasons why we feel this way is because the game didn't launch with many 6v6 experiences to begin with, And when we start to get new maps, we're also getting sprinkled in with remakes. And a lot of the remakes that we're seeing, although they are well received and they do play extremely well in Black Ops Cold War, I think people were expecting for more new. I think people are expecting for more in general when it comes to updates too. I actually came across a tweet from Nero Cinema and I was mind boggled when I read this. Holy shit, so I've been pretty bored of Cold War, haven't played in weeks, thus the lack of videos. Traditional multiplayer seems completely forgotten and dead, so I did some research. Want to guess when the last weapon balance update for multiplayer was? December 10th, 97 days ago. Now, I don't know if this is entirely true because I think I remember some sort of change to the DMR, but that could have been in Warzone, now that I think about it. See, this is where Warzone kind of throws a wrench in the machine. I don't know if the updates are coming for Warzone or if they're coming for Black Ops Cold War. Things get kind of misconstrued. But 97 days ago, I can tell you that there are definitely some weapons in Black Ops Cold War that does not sit well with people. I can definitely say with certainty the new DLC weapons that were added with Season 2 definitely feel way too powerful. I said it in my breakdown video of the new SMG. I mean, that thing is... Why use any AR when that fires way faster, has way less recoil, it can do the same damage from a long range distance? It just doesn't make any sense. The other thing is the skill-based matchmaking. You know, that's always going to be a conversation that people have, but if anything, we see a lot of people kind of being drawn away from Call of Duty recently because of how the matchmaking works and how these pools are created. I don't really know the science behind it. I don't know how the numbers work or anything like that, whether it's based off a kill-death ratio. I'm sure that there's a video made by Drifter or something like that, but it has been proven that it does exist. It is just kind of weird. Like, even when I'm playing on my wife's account, and she's not the best Call of Duty player, and I say that in the most lovingly way, but even she gets pinned up against people that are way high skilled level. I mean, it's just like ridiculously crazy people playing in those lobbies. And I don't know if those people are reverse boosters in general or if it's just because maybe the skill gap is just different nowadays. It's all confusing and it doesn't make any sense. It's nowhere near the same it used to be when you could just hop on and play casually. Now people feel like they need to sweat a bunch of bullets in order to actually do good. And I find trouble with that, especially when you want to try to use a fun weapon or even a challenging one like the E-Tool. I recently got Dark Matter Ultra on that and it was a horrible, horrible time all around. We need to keep a few things in mind, and I hate using this as an excuse because it's been over a year now, but there's still a pandemic. Folks are still working from home. This is still probably very challenging, even though they're probably more comfortable now working from home, but it's still crazy to do that, especially on these huge AAA games. It does make me worried about the future. It really does. I don't know what the next Call of Duty game is going to look like. I don't know if they still plan on releasing one this year, but I would suspect that they are, considering they're still pushing through this entire thing and making the best of it, if you will. This could also be one of the reasons why we're not seeing as much happen on the 6v6 end, but at the same time, it doesn't make sense to say that because we're seeing a ton of other stuff happen in all of these other areas of the game. There's no doubt in my mind this is exactly how the Zombies players felt back during BO4 when they weren't getting any love at all and everything was being rested on Blackout and multiplayer. I'm just keeping in mind while I do this commentary that it's still early on in the seasons. There's a total of 6 seasons planned for Black Ops Cold War, and they do these mid-season updates that bring more maps for 6v6 and more experiences for all of the other modes. So I'm just guessing that there's a lot more planned and a lot more in store, and they're just kind of like drip feeding it out, which is kind of similar to what we're seeing in Warzone right now with this whole outbreak event. So I would assume that there's plenty more to come. And, you know, all the other games that we're basing it off of now, we have the complete version, but Cold War is currently in progress. I don't think that they're going to leave us in the dust when it comes to 6v6. 6v6 is a staple to Call of Duty. All of this talk really does remind me of an interview that was done last year by David Vonderharr. And I'll put a link in the description below if you're interested in reading that. But there was a lot of talk about how the campaign isn't obsolete, how there also needs to be innovation while remaining to keep balance and remembering your core audience while also trying to bring in a new audience. Basically, there's no winning if you're a Call of Duty developer. There really isn't, and I've said that before. But the one thing that I do like about this interview interview is he's not ashamed to talk about slowly bringing features into a game specifically for zombies, and I would think that they're probably applying that same mindset to the rest of the game. Slowly bringing out features and very carefully putting things into the game without, I guess, making too many people mad at once. But yeah, in Treyarch we trust. I said that before, I'll say it again. In Treyarch we trust. I have no doubt in my mind that there's a ton of stuff coming and there's still a lot in the pipeline. But yeah, I'm definitely with you out there. I wish that we had more happening at once. I wish there were more 6v6 maps to play. I know that they're in the pipeline and they're coming, but they're coming very slowly and we would like them a little bit faster. That's pretty much it. That's all I gotta say. I don't think it's dying. I don't think 6v6 is going anywhere. As long as there's Call of Duty, there's going to be some sort of 6v6 playlist, I think. If they ever do get rid of this, many people are going to be upset and probably go and play different games that offer a 6v6 or something of the equivalent. The biggest issue is Call of Duty just doesn't have any competition. It's the king of its own castle and it rules an entire kingdom. Anything that steps up to it either gets banished or just gets shit on completely. It has no competition. I have not heard Battlefield versus Call of Duty in a long time, unless it's comparison videos between the reload of a specific weapon in Battlefield versus the reload of a specific weapon in Call of Duty. People play Call of Duty for Call of Duty. Battlefield is a different experience in my personal opinion, and it's still a great experience and a lot of fun, but Call of Duty does not have any competition. It just doesn't. It grows and grows and grows. The only competition Call of Duty has is itself. And like I said back in 2010 on a video right here on this channel, the only thing that will kill Call of Duty is Call of Duty itself. And that's all I gotta say about it. Let me know what y'all think about it down below in the comment section. If you enjoyed this video, drop a like on it. Subscribe for more videos coming each and every day. And if you haven't yet, please do not forget to ring that bell icon next to the subscribe button. That way YouTube will notify you every single time my videos go live. Alrighty folks, I'll catch you on the next one. Peace.